You already know that two lines are said to be parallel when they lie in the same plane and the distance between them is same, even if these lines are extended in both the directions. Also, we see wide applications of this geometrical concept of parallel lines in our day-to-day life. But as a student, why should you learn to draw parallel lines? Where exactly are you going to need this technique? Just imagine you want to draw or construct a parallelogram whose opposite sides are parallel to each other. How will you draw it without parallel lines? So, we need to learn how to draw a line parallel to the given line. First, let us see how to draw a line parallel to the given line through a point outside this given line by a method in which we are going to use two set squares. Before we begin, let us see the material we require for this construction. We need a pencil, a ruler, 130, 60, 90 degrees set square and 145, 45, 90 degrees set square. We call this set square as 30, 60, 90 degrees set square because it has this angle equal to 30 degrees, this angle equal to 60 degrees and this angle equal to 90 degrees. As this angle is equal to 90 degrees, these two edges of the set square are perpendicular to each other at this point. Similarly, this set square is called as 45, 45, 90 degrees set square because it has this angle equal to 45 degrees, this angle equal to 45 degrees and this angle equal to 90 degrees. Again, as this angle is equal to 90 degrees, these two edges of the set square are perpendicular to each other at this point. So, let us start the actual construction now. Let us draw line L by using pencil and ruler. Let us take a point P outside the line L. Now, through this point P, we want to draw a line such that this line becomes parallel to the given line L. That means the distance between this new line M and given line L should be the same. Here, the distance means the perpendicular distance more precisely. We are going to make use of the perpendicular edges of two set squares to keep the equal distance between the new line M and given line L. Now, we take 30, 60, 90 degrees set square and place its smallest edge exactly on the given line in such a way that the other perpendicular edge passes through the outside point P. We hold this set square tight in the position and you can see that this edge is perpendicular to the given line at this point A on the given line. So that a straight line joining points P and point A indicates perpendicular distance of point P from line L. Hence, if we draw a new line M passing through point P such that this distance PA remains equal, this new line M will be parallel to the given line L. For this, we take 45, 45, 90 degrees set square and place it in such a way that this point is on the point P. You can see that these two perpendicular edges are now touching each other. So that if we draw a new line M passing through point P and a transversal T along the touching perpendicular edges, we get a pair of interior alternate angles which are congruent. Hence, according to alternate angles test of parallel lines, the new line M will be parallel to the given line L. Now, we hold these two set squares tight in the position and then we draw a line along this edge of the set square through point P. Let us name this line as line M. So, we have constructed a line M through an outside point P such that this line M is at a perpendicular distance PA from the given line L. And both the lines, line M and line L, are lying in the same plane. Hence, the line M which we have constructed is parallel to the given line L. So, an important point here is, it is possible to construct a line M parallel to given line L even if you have set squares with no markings for measurement of distance, because our construction is based on the concept of perpendicular distance between the two lines, and so eventually based on formation of two congruent interior alternate angles both equal to 90 degrees and has no relation with the measurement of distance between the two lines. Let us learn another method to draw a line parallel to the given line through a point outside this given line using a single set square. Let us use this 45, 45, 90 degrees set square for our construction. Let's draw line L by using pencil and ruler. Let us take a point P outside the line L. Now, we want to draw a line through the point P such that this line becomes parallel to the given line L. Now, we take 45, 45, 90 degrees set square and place one of its perpendicular edges exactly on the given line in such a way that the other perpendicular edge passes through the outside point P. We hold the set square tight in the position and you can see that this edge is perpendicular to the given line at this point A on the given line. Let us draw segment PA perpendicular to line L. Segment PA indicates perpendicular distance of point P from line L. Let us measure segment PA. Here, PA is equal to 6 centimeters. Let us take another point B on the line L. Now, we take 45, 45, 90 degrees set square and place one of its perpendicular edges exactly on the given line L in such a way that this intersection point of set square is on point B. We hold the set square tight in the position and you can see that this edge is perpendicular to the given line at this point B. Hence, if we draw a segment passing through point B along this edge such that it is equal to segment PA, which is nothing but 6 centimeters, we get a new point Q, so that QB is equal to 6 centimeters and it is perpendicular to the line L at point B. Now, we draw a single line passing through points P and Q both and name this line as M. Now, in this case, line M is at equal distance PA or QB from line L and both these lines lie in the same plane. Hence, line M is parallel to the given line L. As you have seen, we have used a set square to draw perpendicular on the given line. Instead, you can also use a compass to draw a perpendicular, which you have already studied in the previous standard.